Thank you everyone for joining this new journey with us, the magic workshop of 28 days by Rhonda Byrne. Thank you, and you all are welcome in the world of the magic. So let me brief about the first day, what we have to do, and some background of this book, why we are doing this book, and what is there actually in this book. So the magic book is written by Rhonda Byrne, who already written the secret book, and after that this book has come. In this book she has talked about lot about the gratitude. The magic has been created by the gratitude. So if you people have the book, so you can read the initial pages and find out what is the importance of the magic, or what is the importance of the gratitude in our life. If you remember, when we were as a child, so we used to see small things, like, and it feels like, oh my god, this is a new thing happening to us. Even if our teeth is broken, so we are taking as like a fairy has come, angel has come and taken my teeth, and new teeth will come after some day, and Santa will come on the Christmas and give me the gifts. So all the things we used to feel as a magic. But as we are grown up, so somewhere magic has been lost from our life. But if you remember, the power of magic is still there. Be kid again, be child again, and enjoy the magic in your life. Almost the 2000 years back, there was a one saying, whoever has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what he has will be taken from him. So this is this sentence has been written, and what is the missing part there? There was the missing part is the gratitude. Whoever has the gratitude will be given more, and he or she will have an abundance. Whoever does not have the gratitude, even what he or she has will be taken from him or her. I know this is very hard line to say that, like, if we will not show the gratitude, whatever we have, so that will taken from us. But that is really, really true. So it is very important, we should be grateful what we have, and by that practice we can invite the more good moments in our life to enjoy the happiness and giving the gratitude. Even they have quoted in Quran, when God proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will give you more, but if you are not grateful or ungrateful, verily my punishment is indeed severe. So by that way, they are trying to tell us the meaning of gratitude, the power of the gratitude. Those gratitude powers we will discuss for 28 days, how it can change our life. And everybody knows, mostly in this group, what is the law of attraction. And this book is majorly based on law of attraction. The law of attraction is, what we are asking, what we are sending in the universe, that is coming back to us multiple times. If we are cribbing, criticizing the things all the time, for example, I don't like my job, I have not got enough money, I can't find my perfect partner, so these all are the things will multiply, and there is no gratitude in all these things. But if we will see whatever we have, then the things will open differently for us. New opportunities will come to us. Our relationship will become better than before. So for example, we can, if we are saying, I love my job, my family is very supportive, I had very good vacation, I enjoyed a lot. So these vibrations have the different frequency, high level of the frequency, which will invite the more higher frequency in our life. So this is our choice. God has given us the conscious. So this is our choice. Either we want to vibrate on the positive frequency or the negative frequency. So, and law of attraction, what we are giving, that is coming back to us in the multiple time. Always remember, and as the Newton also said, that every action always has an opposite and equal reaction. So similar way the magic works. So now I am taking you, because so many in our literature, all the people, if you will say Muhammad, Quran, Buddha, even Krishna, our King David, Jesus, always used to give the gratitude before doing any miracle. Lot of people name, they have given Mahatma Gandhi, Mother Teresa, Dalai Lama, Shakespeare, Plato, so many names, Einstein, Newton, the people all know the power of the gratitude. And the people have used the power of gratitude and used that power in their day-to-day life to do the miracles. Albert Einstein, we all know that person, what he has given to the world. And his saying is only the thank you every day. Thousands time in a day he used to say the gratitude to the people who changed the life of his. Similar way Newton has given. So all these scientists have made so many changes for the mankind. And they are vibrating on the frequency of the gratitude. So that is the power of gratitude. Now the Rhonda is also telling about the gratitude, how it has changed his life, her life actually. So what she is talking about here, she explained the concept like 6 years ago when she was knowing that concept. If you will ask, was she grateful? Yes, I used to say thank you to everyone. When I used to get the gift, when somebody is giving me honor or respect, I used to say thank you. So that means I am grateful. No, that is not the meaning of being grateful. If we are saying normally thank you as a sophistication, as a sophisticated manner, that doesn't mean we are grateful from inside. The meaning of grateful is more bigger than. So she was saying she used to use the thank you everywhere, but she was not knowing the value of that gratefulness. So she was still in the depth, she was in a bad relationship, she was in the bad of the health, everything was so bad. But all of the sudden, when she realized the secret of the life, the magic of the life, the gratefulness, what is the meaning of the gratitude in actual, when she start vibrating on that frequency, everything has changed. Her life has changed and she is able to change all others' life. She has brought the magic or the gratitude in all of us. She has written this book and this has changed the whole over the world. And definitely it is going to change your life now. So what is, let me take you further in this. How we can make our things better, how it's going to affect our life. We are going to do this magic book. This book has 28 chapters, and 28 chapters means divided in the 28 days. And 28 days, for the initial 12 days, we will vibrate on the frequency what we have, what we achieved in the past. So we will cover only our past, what gifts, what blessings we got, and what blessings we have today. All these things we will cover in 12 days. After that, after next 10 days, we will talk about our desires, our dreams, everything what we want from the future. We will vibrate on the future frequency. And after that, we will do the 6 days practice, which is highest level of the vibration, where we will give the gratitude to the universe and we will connect with the universe to get our things done. Okay, so if we are missing any day, this is perfectly fine. Don't lose the track. Next day you can do the practice, next day you can finish your activity to make the momentum. Okay, so now what we have to do. First thing, we have to find out a magical notepad for ourselves. Find out one diary, one notepad for yourself where you can write all the magical workshop related things. That will be for your lifetime. where you can write your blessings, where you can write your day-to-day activities, where you are going to write your dreams and desire lists. So first we have to find out a magical notepad for yourself. Second thing, a magical pen. I will prefer, if you are going to write your magical journey, please write with a red pen, because red is the vibrating energy which is going to generate the positivity in your life. So use the red pen and magical notepad and share the pictures of your magical notepad in the group today. Okay, so after finding the magical notepad for yourself, what next you have to do? Today you have to sit somewhere for half an hour, some calmly after doing the meditation, or if you are feeling comfortable, in a some place where you can find some time for yourself. Sit calmly there and write all your dreams there in that notepad. Start your journey by writing your desire list. You can write your 10 desires, you can write more than that. Whatever desires, small, big, everything, whatever you have in your mind, write in that notepad with a red pen. For example, if you are looking for a dream job, what type of job you are looking for, what type of people you are looking for, what type of salary you are looking for, what type of travel you are looking for, write the complete paragraph, write the complete points about your dream job in your dream list. Similar way, if you are looking for the money, what type of money you are looking for, what you are going to do with that money, are you going to sponsor for your children, are you going to travel the world, are you going to help your parents, are you going to make your home by that money, what you are going to do by that money, so, and or you are going to donate something of that, whatever is the plan, whatever your desired list of the money, you can write. If you are looking for a perfect partner, what qualities you are looking in that person, what relationship actually you are looking, how you want to improve, write all these things in the desire list. If you are looking for the health, what type of health you are looking, what is your ideal body you are looking for, what you want to do, what type of clothes you want to wear, what type of car you want to drive, you write here all the things minutely, and even in the big dreams, small dreams, today's dream, tomorrow dream, 1 week type dream, 1 month, 1 year dream, whatever categories, read and write, read in the mind and write in the book. Okay, so take a picture. I prefer do the meditation before doing this, so that you can get the clear focus, all the positive energies around you. So then write all these your dream lists. Even if you're looking for an educational qualification degree, or if you want to be a doctor or whatever you want the profession, you can write in that dream list. And basically you can divide into the categories of health and body, career and work, money, relationships, personal desires, material things. These categories you can find out which suits you, where you want to vibrate, where you want to write your things. Write all the things there, because this list is very important. We are going to work on this list for these 28 days, even after 28 days also. Okay, so this is the one activity what we have to do, and after that we are going to start our first day, which is day one. Count your blessings. So our day one is count your blessings. So what is the meaning there? The quotation in the magic book is written, when I started counting my blessings, my whole life turned around. When we are grateful for the things what we have, either it's small or big, it's going to increase. It's going to increase. If you have very little money, be grateful for that, because it's going to multiply if you are grateful for that. If you have broken relationship, find out the points of the gratefulness in that relationship. It will heal your relationship. If you are looking for a dream job, give the gratitude to your current job. Find out the positive points in your current job. It will come back, or it will give you the pleasure in the current moment. At the same time, it will invite your dream job in your life. Okay, the flip side of this thinking is, if we are not vibrating on the gratefulness frequencies, if we are not on the gratitude side, we are on the other side. We are on the negative side, we will start counting the negative sides things if we are not counting the positive blessings. So we start complaining, we start finding out what are the gaps, what are the weaknesses, what is the negativeness in the situation, in the person. That will drain our all the energies, and it will not take us anywhere. Negative vibrations, negative energies will not solve any situation. It will not only make our present bad, but it will also not help us to get our future invite in our life. So that is the reason. What is the quotation there? Better to lose count while naming your blessings than to lose your blessings to counting your troubles. So if you are counting your blessings and you are not finding how many blessings are there, that is really awesome. Rather than counting the complaints or the negative things around us, rather than counting on that, always try to vibrate on the positive things, what we have, what we got in our life. So what we have to do about this day one, we have to find out the 10 blessings which are vibrating around us all the day, small and big. Everything is there around us. We have to count them and write in your magical notepad. So what Einstein used to do, Einstein used to write the blessing or read the blessing, and at the same time he found out the reason why he is grateful. So that is the difference when we are just saying thank you and when we are mentioning the reason. Thank you for coming for the workshop. Thank you for joining the meditation. Thank you for being present there. Thank you for coming as a support for me. Thank you for providing all the money to me. So there is a reason, there is a for, there is a because, something is there. Why you are thankful for that person? If you are thankful to your parents who made the food for you, your mother, or your parents who have given the education to you to grow at this level. So there is a reason behind it. You have to find out the reason. What are the reason behind why you are grateful? Because that will give you the actual meaning of the gratefulness. That is different than only saying the thank you. That is the difference. So now some templates are there in given chapter 1, which we will share in the group also. So I am truly blessed to have, whatever reason you can write, because why. I am so happy and grateful for, because. I am truly grateful for, because. With all my heart, thank you for, because. So these are the templates. You can choose any of the template. For example, I have chosen, my template is, I am thankful to Supreme God for giving me divine blessings for the day. I am thankful to my parents for giving me support. I am thankful to my office workers who are helping me, for giving support, respect and timely work done for me. Okay, so similar way you can find out the for reason, because of, what is the reason why you are grateful, and write down the day one. You will write in the magical notepad day one and 10 blessings. Blessings can be related to anything around you. Okay, and after writing all these 10 blessings, you have to read these blessings one by one. You can read loudly or you can read by your heart only, and you will see 3 times thank you for each and every blessing what you have written. Okay, and with the name of that person. For example, if you are writing the gratitude for your friend. For example, I am taking one example here. If my friend's name is Shabnam, so I am saying thank you, Shabnam. So by that way, you can say thank you, Supreme God. Thank you, my mother. Thank you. Whoever blessing you have written, you have to say 3 times thank you and read it. Read it loudly and say 3 times thank you with the name of the person. If you are not finding anything, that is also possible because you just started the journey. When you will finish the journey, you cannot say that you are not finding the blessing around you, because blessing is always there. This is our way of seeing the blessing. So you can see the blessing to the Supreme God, you can see the blessing to the universe, you can see the blessing to the beautiful nature, earth, even sun. In our all the religious societies, if you see, we are giving the gratitude in the morning to the sun. Some people are giving water to the sun as a symbolic gratitude, as a symbolic thank you. You are there because sun has so much light and energy to heal the people, heal the universe, heal the nature by default. So sun is the biggest power. So you can give the gratitude to the sun or anything it is coming to you. So you have to write these 10 blessings, and this is the practice you have to follow for next 27 days. All these you have to write the 10 blessings. Now the timing, you have to write these blessings early in the morning as you wake up. But if it's not possible, you can write when you are starting your day. You can take your magical notepad near your bedside. So you can take the notepad in the morning and write the 10 blessings. This is the best time. And if you are not able to do at that time, when you are starting your day, maybe you just reach in the office, just write your blessing. As fast as you get the time in the morning, you have to write the blessing. And I am almost doing the last 2 years these practices, and I am writing the blessings every day. Either I am doing this workshop or not doing this workshop, and it makes me more focused, more centered in the morning. And if I am not writing the blessing, I can find out the difference. What is the difference in attitude? Okay, so similar way, please write the blessing for 28 days and make a practice of this, habit of this. So subjects, what you can choose, you can give to your health, you can give the blessing to your health, you can give to your work and success, you can give blessing, write the thank you to money, to relationship, to your passion, to your happiness, to your love, your life, to the nature, planet Earth, air, water and the sun, material goods and services, any subject of your choice, you can write the blessing for that. Okay, so I'm going to brief today's day one. One is, first thing in the morning, make a list of 10 blessings in your life you are grateful for. Write why you are grateful for each blessing. Third thing is, go back and read your list either in your mind or out loud. When you get the end of each one, say thank you, the name, and feel the gratitude of that blessing as much as possible. Repeat this practice for next 27 days and read tomorrow's magical practice today. So this is the briefing of the day one. In day two, we are going to do the magic rock. Let me brief you, because you have to find out the magic rock today also. So what is the magic rock? So magic rock is any rock which is you can hold in your palm and you can close your fingers, and that particular rock inside that your fist, or you are easily hold that in your hand. So that magical rock you have to find, and it should not have sharp edges. It should be comfortable in your hand. We will show some pictures also of the magical rock in the group, so that you people can find out and share your magical rock. So what is that? Actually, you can find out the rock near to your garden near to your home or some nearby place from the roadside, it is perfectly fine. Because this rock is a simple rock, but you are going to make it magical rock. How you are going to make it magical rock? That will depend the practice, how we are going to do. This is the day 2. So that we will cover tomorrow. But you have to find out the rock also today, so that you can understand what you have to do with that. Find out the comfortable rock for you, which you are going to convert in the magical rock. So magical rock, the concept is that we will do the gratitude before going to sleep. So by that way, we are starting our day with the count of our blessings and ending our day by magical rock in our hand, and find out the best moment of the day and lock that moment in the magical rock, and then we will sleep. By that way, we will make the simple rock as a magical rock. And we will do this practice also for next 27 days, so that we can give the power to that magical rock. So that will be your rock, which is going to convert into the magical rock. The chapter I will brief tomorrow again, little bit day 2. So this is all about for day 1. So what we have to do? We have to find out the magical notepad. We have to find out the pen for ourselves. We have to find out the rock, which we are going to make the magical rock. These 3 things we have to do today. Then in the magical notepad, you have to write your all the dreams, all the desires in the starting page. After that, you have to write the 10 blessings. Day 1 in the morning, you have to write the 10 blessings, what you have around you. And you have to say thank you, thank you, thank you for each and every blessing. Okay, so and in the group, what you have to do, you have to share the one thank you moment of the day. During the day, you will find so many things. Maybe you will able to travel safely to your job, which is definitely is there, and you are finding some promotion, or do you have birthday, or you have party, whatever occasion is coming to you, or even if you are finding some good food, favorite food of yours, or you are finding one of the good friend you are going to meet, you have to share one thank you moment in the group. And when the other people will share thank you moment in the group, you have to appreciate and attach yourself with their achievement. Okay, so that is the logic. Everyone appreciate everyone's thank you moment. Congratulate the person, use the positive words. Make your dictionary ready with your positive words. Awesome, bravo, you did very well. Use the name of the person and give congratulations, congrats to the person, and enjoy with him or her what the person is sharing with you. And this is the group which we have created for you, by you only. So we have to create and keep the positive energy all the time, because law of attraction is working. If we are putting the positive energy, we will receive back. We are giving the positive energy, we will receive back. So this is practical implementation of positive energy. You will see how the people are sharing, especially the people who are doing this workshop with me third time or fourth time. You will see how they are sharing their thank you moment. Even if you are finding the bright day in your city, that is also the thank you moment. After so many rainy days, there is a beautiful sun in the sky. Thank you, Supreme God, for giving the beautiful light for the day. So that is the one thank you moment. Anything, if some plant, if flowers are coming in your garden, you can share that flowers. Thank you, I saw beautiful flowers today. You can also share the pics of them. You have to find out the beauty around you and appreciate other people, and they will also appreciate and give you the positive energy. So this is all. And attendance sharing we used to do at the end of the day, where you will share, count your blessings, finding the magical notepad, magical rock, and your thank you moment. So these 4 things we will share as an attendance pattern if you all the these done, then you will say, yes, I am done for the day. Magical rock you will do before going to sleep. Okay, so I know a lot of things are there because this is the initial days, 2-3 days. Till day 3, you have so many things to collect with you guys. After that, you will get the pattern. You will know how the things will flow. It will be easy. And don't forget, this is the workshop and the certification of gratitude you are doing. So you need to do something. It's just not just like you are coming here and listening to the session and you are not doing anything. So this is not like that. I am only the facilitator who are helping you to briefing the session or chapter. You have to read the chapter, you have to do the activities to change your life, to make positivity in your life and get your dreams done. So this is your work you have to do. I am just helping you out and I am also doing with you guys. Okay, so thank you everyone, all the 12 people who joined with me in this journey. And after day 3, we will see if people are not doing the activities, the other people, politely we will eliminate them, because this is not because they will take the energy from the group and they are not contributing, then it will be difficult, because either they are not vibrating on the positive side, they will automatically go on the negative side. So we will keep the people who are active in the group. Okay, so thank you for understanding and thank you for joining the session. We will meet tomorrow with day 2 briefing of the session. God bless you all.